Hello, in this class of GSM, we will be studying about GSM cells. GSM cells, so very first, what is cell? So I can say that smallest cell is the smallest coverage area. So the basic definition of a cell is smallest coverage area. So smallest coverage area of whom? So this is basically a tower, and with tower I have attached a BDS. On this tower we have make three sectors and sector names as alpha, beta and gamma. Now what are alpha, beta and gamma? So actually what we want, that BDS should provide a coverage with an angle of 360 degrees. So that means I require that my BDS should cover whole area. So I can form that this is a 360 degree angle or a complete circle. But it is not practically possible to give 360 degree coverage with a single antenna. So I have divided the whole circle into three parts at an angle of 120 degree each. So I will draw again. This is my 360 degree. So I have divided this 360 degree into three parts at an angle of 120 degree each, so that I can have full coverage in this complete circle. So I named as that, okay, this 0 to 120 degree will be my alpha. This could be beta and this could be gamma. Where alpha, beta and gamma, that means the parts, I named it as these are my sectors. As this is basically the pattern with the BDS, as this BDS has provided a coverage of 360 degree. Now I have attached an antenna, that means one antenna for alpha sector, one antenna for beta sector and one for gamma sector. So when I focus on coverage area of this antenna, that means this alpha, the smallest coverage area, so I can name it as that, okay, this is my cell. So here I have a cell and cell. So this cell, that means smallest coverage area, is basically in concern to this transceiver or antenna. But when I focus on a BTS, it okay, this is the BTS who ultimately providing the coverage. So smallest coverage area of a BTS, which is itself a circle of 360 degree. So the smallest coverage area of this BTS will also be called as a cell. So that's why this is smallest coverage area. A cell is the smallest coverage area. When taking the concern of a BTS, so this one will form my cell. When I'm taking the concern of only one antenna, so the smallest coverage area will be my cell. But commonly we name this as a cell, that means smallest coverage area of BDS. But in some terms, we represent with antenna itself. That's why I have dictated it to you. Now, smallest coverage area of a BDS, I can name that, okay, this is my cell. Now, a cell has three sectors in it at an angle of 120 degree. And 120 degree, that means alpha, beta and gamma. So, why GSM is a cellular technology, wireless cell system, cellular structures, cell phones, everything is related to cell. As we have cellular technology, we name cell phones. So, cell phones are basically the phones that can have access with the cell. So cell phones, cellular technology. So also the cellular structure. So if I compare the GSM architecture, that okay, this is the whole area where I need to perform, where I need to give GSM. So practically if I make these cells, so I'm having number of cells. So if I'm forming number of cells together, 1, 2, 3, so on up to, so this will form my complete cellular structure. And a cell phone here or a mobile phone here who is accessing this cell will be cell phone, or it is able to access the cell. Now, okay, that number of cells, we require cellular structure. But the question arises that what could be the shape of cell? What could be the shape of the cell? This is the normal question. If practically, that means, sorry, in theoretical concept has a dealing that, okay, the cell has hexagonal shape. But as I'm talking that it is forming a 360 degree angle, it can't make its shape hexagonal itself. So why theoretically I have hexagonal shape of the cell? So as per my concept of 360 degree, I have a circular shape. But I can't give circular shape to the cell, or it is not practically possible to achieve direct circles, because you can have coverage hole in betweens. These are called coverage holes. As coverage holes are the areas where I'm not able to have any network access. So these are forming my coverage holes in an area, and as per theoretical concept, I have hexagonal shape. Now let's discuss how hexagonal shape is achieved. Practically, for each and every cell, I require overlapping. So why I require, there should be minimum 2 or 3% overlapping. So now see, as in order to remove the coverage holes, that okay, I can't define the boundary of a simple circular shape, so I require that my cells should be overlapped to 2 or 3% so that I can't have any coverage hole in the network and user will have full coverage access. So when I completed for this particular cell, I have number of neighbors. When I joined the overlapping area, or I named it as, this will be my one cell. Now see the outer boundaries of this. So when I see the outer boundaries, I have a shape, and this shape is hexagonal. Because of this concept, because of overlapping of the cells and with this diagrammatically representation of an area, theoretically I named it as it is as total theoretical representation. So I named it as that, okay, my shape of the cell is hexagonal. But practically, when I compare the shape of the cell with overlapping and all, sometimes I achieve hexagonal, sometimes I not. So it means that it is hexagonal theoretically, but practically it is haphazard dependent. Sometimes I have never defined, sometimes I don't have, because I can have call drop also in my network. So it totally dependent on the area. It totally dependent on the planning. So what are the neighbors? What are the boundaries? How my cell is overlapping? So I can decide the shape of the cell. Theoretical concept of the shape of the cell, I have represented. So this is theoretical shape of the cell, and practically it could be any haphazard, sometimes any. So this, or maybe coverage extends up to this one, I am having overlapping. So haphazard shape of the cell in practical point of view, and it totally depends on the areas. So if I am making a cell over here, again I require to divide it into some parts, because I need to define sectors as alpha, beta and gamma. So I can say that I have cell 1, cell 2, cell 3, then I have cell 4, cell 5, cell 6. So I have represented the total number of 6 cells in this area. So this, that means the full area should be comprises of like this number of cells. So this will form my cellular structure. Cellular structure and correspondingly cellular technology. Now, if I complete this area, so that means I require to provide coverage to this area also, to this area also, in this diagrammatically representation, or I require to full complete my area. So it is dependent upon antenna orientations and all. Sometimes I have area in which I have very less coverage, or maybe not. So areas where I am not having some coverage or very less coverage will be my, named it as this one, as coverage hole. But I don't require coverage hole in my area. So I have a regular drive test to the areas. There we can find out the coverage hole. And then optimization, that means we are trying to provide the coverage to that particular area, so that we have 99% on 98% covered area. So when I compare one cell, okay, this is my cell. Now this, that means group of cells. If I have this, that means group of cells. Now this one will be called as cluster. So I can name it as cluster is a group of cells. I need to define the boundary of a cell and then cluster 1, cluster 2 and so on up to. Like this, I have number of clusters in a complete area. Now these, that is the users here at this end will be called center cell users. And users here at this end, that means at the boundary, will be called as cell edge users. And when we are crossing boundaries, we require a procedure, and that is handover. Handover from one cell to another cell. For not breaking of a call, for continuous call, we require a regular handovers in a area. So, cellular structure and shape of the cell we have discussed in this class. Now, we have named it as a single as my cell, group, so I'm making a group. So group will be called as cluster, and in a complete area where I am having cells, a number of cluster will be my PLMN area. Which is public, local, mobile, network area, which is called as PLMN area. Now PLMN area is according to the locations. So in order to have a code of a location, I have LAC, which is location area code. And this LAC or location area code is as per the locations, like Delhi, Mumbai. In between Delhi and Mumbai, I have number of areas. So the area from which I am will be my location area and location area code. The smallest unit is cell. Then we have cluster, PLMN according to the locations. Then we have area under 1 MSC, then complete nations area. So hierarchy go like this, but cellular technology or the smallest unit in GSM is a cell, which is the smallest coverage area. So this is all for today's class. We will continue in our next class. Thank you so much.